Hashtag, my body, my choice. At what point would the things we stigmatize today become acceptable tomorrow? I read comments on Instagram about a recent US protest on my body, my choice, hashtag rally for abortion justice. I saw how people marched in solidarity to protect abortion rights and show their support for reproductive health and rights for women in New London, Connecticut. This was because of the abortion ban that was recently passed in Texas, as most people saw it as a threat to the rights of women across the country and across the world. Several people in the US and the most parts of the world believe that if women's reproductive rights or people's rights to express their sexuality are threatened in one part of the world, that means they are also threatened everywhere. You will recall that during the 2016 presidential campaign, Hillary Clinton repeatedly spoke out in support of the rights of women to have abortions. Abortion remained a contentious issue in that election, in the US election 2016, with 56% of Americans supporting its legalization in most cases, and only 41% in opposition. Now, a school of thought believes that as women, they shouldn't have to debate whether they have the right to choose what they do with their bodies, and that none must interfere with their personal choices for what's best for themselves. Now, have you heard that in a Superman comics edition, John Kent, the new Superman, the son of Clark Kent and Lois Lane, is bisexual and is in a relationship with a guy? At what point do we say enough is enough? And like Tomi Arayomi clearly stated, this is not an LGBTQ agenda. This is an agenda for our children. And for this one, my simple question is, what is our media content parallel response? So if the things we stigmatized yesterday are now becoming acceptable to today, at what point would the things we stigmatize today become acceptable tomorrow? If we embrace the concept of hashtag my body, my choice in the context of fighting to defend women's rights to abortion, then why are we raising eyebrows to other similar interest groups springing up, like those who say that being gay is a function of nature and not nurture? Over the years, and with legislation, lobbying, and pushing their goals, they argued that if the civil rights movement showed it was wrong to discriminate against people based on their color or the color of their skin, then it was wrong to discriminate based on nature's choice on how they were programmed to love. It is on this ground that some people now claim that being a pedophile or even practicing bestiality are ways they are programmed to love. So do we support the right of the women to say it is her body and her choice on one hand, and turn a blind eye to what the rights of our children are? Do we argue in support of the lady on one hand and turn a blind eye on the rights of the fetus on the other? Therefore, if the things we stigmatized yesterday are now becoming acceptable to today, at what point would the things we stigmatize today become acceptable tomorrow?
Wow. Peter, you're about to open a can of worms.
Yeah.
And we don't even have the time for it. But, that's, you know, I just share something that I heard, you know, one of the most profound things I've heard about all this 2 days ago. Some guy was speaking and he said that, you know, he has no issues with adults, you know, choosing who they want to love or who they don't want to love, choosing who they want to procreate with, or, you know, adults, you're an adult, make your choices. What he has a problem with is when you now take this to his children, right? And that's where I have a problem. That's why I draw the line as well. Because I'm not telling your children to live a certain way. They're your children. So don't come and tell my children what to believe, what is right, what is wrong, who to love, who not. Don't bring it to my children. Because they're children. They don't yet have the faculty and the agency to make the right decisions. That's why they're children. That's why they're called minors legally, right? So as far as you're an adult, choose whatever you want. I'm not anti anything, right? I'm just anti common sense, whatever is common sense to you.
Mm.
But where I draw the line is where you now bring your beliefs, your biases, your prejudices, and start to feed it to my children that don't have that agency and faculty to decide what is wrong from this right. And then you start to feed them these things from that young age, and then you start to reprogram my children, that's where there's a problem. Mm. So that's really just my own, you know, opinion to this.
Well, I see. You've passed the battle to my area. With due respect to the way things are in the world now, the world is very complex now. There are things we overlooked before. There are things we call taboo, and some persons are trying to accept it. But let's have it. Let's draw the line. We Africans, or we Nigerians, or we whatever we are, we should decide what we want for ourselves. You should not accept what every other person is saying, that this is their definition of life and therefore it must be shoved down your throat. No.
Copy and paste again.
Of course, we should be careful about what our children feed from social media. When they grow, when you teach them the right values, they will understand life on their own and make decisions, good decisions for themselves.
Absolutely.
You know, that's what we call the concept of greater good, right? Mm. If my decision, howbeit, makes me happy, but on the greater good, makes a lot of people, hurts a lot of people, disorients a lot of people, then I must go back to change that decision. Okay. It's very, really, really very important. And I think the hashtag my body, my choice can also be likened to the whole do you. I can be doing me and driving and drinking champagne and I cause an accident. I was doing me, but you know, I've created a bad greater good. So let's think about.
All right, Ejimai, please.
Yes, that concept is called unitarianism, the greatest good for the greatest number of people. For me, I just want to preach against extremism. That's my own point, against extremism on any level. If you have a position that is contrary to mine, please respect it. I'm going to respect your position, and we're going to live amicably. As much as possible, let us not, you know, take down everything that we see around us. We should be able to see from what is popular and what in each person's case they think is right or is wrong. Mm. So whatever works for you, let it work for you. You don't have to come out and be so insensitive to other people's position. But I'm not going to say don't be who you are. I'm just going to say let us be careful of extremism.
Thank you very much, Ejimai. And like Tolu said, it's a clarion call. Let's invest in people who have positive content, because we have to build a parallel narrative. We've not come to the end of the week's episode on the Advocate. However, the Advocate continues on our social media platforms on Facebook, Plus TV Africa, hashtag The Advocate NG, and Instagram at Plus TV Africa, hashtag The Advocate NG. To catch up with previous episodes, go to Plus TV Africa.com/TheAdvocateNG. Don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel, Plus TV Africa. Till next week, same time on this station, let's keep advocating for a better society.